Hi dear students, welcome to the social science online class, the last part of history, second chapter, that is medieval India and political transition. In our last class, we have learned the reforms that were made by Alauddin Khilji and Muhammad bin Tughlaq. In this session, we are going to learn the contributions of Delhi Sultans. Before going to understand the contribution of Delhi Sultans, we should know the last two dynasties that ruled Delhi Sultanate, namely Sayyid dynasty and Lodhi dynasty. The Sayyid dynasty was the fourth dynasty of Delhi Sultanate, with four rulers ruling from 1440 to 1451. Khizr Khan was the founder of the Sayyid dynasty. In the beginning, Khizr Khan was a governor of Multan under the Tughlaq ruler Firoz Shah Tughlaq, and he was well known to be an able administrator during that time. Khizr Khan established his rule in Doab, Bian and Gwalior regions. He suppressed many rebellions and established law and order, ensuring peace. During his rule, coins were continued to be struck in the name of previous Tughlaq rulers. Muhammad Shah, Alauddin and Alam Shah were the prominent rulers of Sayyid dynasty. Bahlul Lodhi defeated Alam Shah and brought an end to the rule of the Sayyid dynasty. The Lodhi dynasty was an Afghan dynasty that ruled the Delhi Sultanate from 1451 to 1526. It was the last dynasty of Delhi Sultanate and was founded by Bahlul Khan Lodhi when he replaced the Sayyid dynasty. Bahlul Khan Lodhi ascended the throne of Delhi Sultanate on 19th April 1451. The most important event of his rule was the conquest of Jaunpur. Bahlul Khan Lodhi spent most of his time in fighting against Sharikh dynasty and ultimately annexed it. Sikandar Lodhi, the second son of Bahlul Khan Lodhi, succeeded him after his death on 17 July 1489. Sikandar Lodhi founded Agra in 1504 and built a mosque. He shifted the capital from Delhi to Agra. സികന്ദർ ലോധി, അബോളിഷ്ഡ് കോൺ ഡ്യൂട്ടീസ് ആൻഡ് പാറ്റണൈസ്ഡ് ട്രേഡ് ആൻഡ് കൊമേഴ്സ്. ആസ് എ സ്കോളർ ഹി പാറ്റണൈസ്ഡ് ലേണിംഗ് ആൻഡ് ഓർഡേർഡ് സാംസ്ക്രിറ്റ് വർക്ക് ഇൻ മെഡിസിൻസ് ടു ബി ട്രാൻസ്ലേറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ടു പേർഷ്യൻ ലാംഗ്വേജ്. His greatest achievement was the conquest and annexation of Bihar region. Ibrahim Lodi, the youngest son of Sikandar Lodi, was the last ruler of Lodi dynasty. He had the qualities of an excellent warrior, but he was rash and impolitic in his decisions and actions. Ibrahim Lodi faced numerous rebellions and kept out of the opposition for almost a decade. Ibrahim Lodi was engaged in warfare with the Afghans and the Mughal Empire for almost of his region and died trying to keep the Lodi dynasty from annihilation. Ibrahim Lodi was defeated in 1526 at the Battle of Panipat. This marked the end of Lodi dynasty and the rise of the Mughal Empire in India led by Babur. Now let us understand the contribution of Delhi Sultans. At first, the administrative system. Most of the Delhi Sultans were dictatorial rulers. They were also the commanders of the army and chief justice. The administration was in accordance to Quran. Sardars, Amirs and Ulemas had a considerable influence over the administration. The central government had departments like defense, foreign affairs, postal, charity and endowment for effective administration. These departments were headed by ministers and officials. The kingdom was divided into many provinces. These administrative divisions were headed by Shikdar, Amin and Chowkidars. The collection of revenue, maintenance of law and order, providing education facilities, and ensuring cleanliness were the main roles of these officials. Kharaj, Zakat, Jizya, Khums, tax on a property without hire, import duty, house tax were the main source of income during the rule of sultans. There were officials for the collection of taxes, quasis, aided the sultans in dispensing justice in provinces and towns. Social system. During the rule of Delhi Sultans, the Muslims and the Hindu communities had their traditional customs and faith. The Hindu Bhakti saints and Sufi saints of Muslim communities ushered in social changes into the old social system. In the beginning, only Turk Sardars were only appointed to the higher administrative positions. Later, on their influence waned. During the reign of Khilji and Tughlaq, local people who had converted into Islam had more opportunities. Hindus were appointed as associate officers and clerk in revenue department. The ruling class of this time got introduced into the Indian way of dressing, beverages, food and music, and cultural aspects. Slavery was in practice. Prisoners of wars were named their slaves. There were many women slaves in palace. The status of women was not healthy. Parda system and child marriage were in practice. Women from higher social classes participated in fine arts. The rural women participated in agriculture and household activities. Economic situation. The sultans brought in major changes in the areas of agriculture. The old system of tax fixation and revenue collections were changed. The mandatory payment of tax by both the rich farmers and poor farmers were the main features of the revenue policy adopted during the rule of sultans. The transport and communication were improved. Roads were built all across from Gujarat to Bengal. The foreign merchants visited all the small and big markets of the medieval India, and some settled here itself. This provided a lot of impetus to craftsmen. The Indian art craft entered the European markets. The sultans and the prominent businessmen were running factories of gold and silver ornaments and silk looms. Literature. Many foreign authors and historians were under the royal patronage of Sultan. The writings are in Persian and Arabic languages. A famous scholar named Al-Biruni was in the court of Muhammad Ghori. He was a philosopher, mathematician, and also a writer. Al-Biruni wrote a book named Kitab ul Hind on the social, political, economic, and religious aspects of India. Hasan Nizami wrote Tajul Masir, Minhaj us Siraj wrote Tabakkal e Nasiri, Amir Khusro wrote 6 books and provided details about Hindu and Muslim culture. He is called the Indian Parrot. Sayyuddin Barani wrote Tariki Firoshahi, and Firosha Tughlaq wrote Fadhat e Firoshahi. Now let us see the contribution of Delhi Sultans in the field of art and architecture. The Delhi Sultans introduced a new style of architecture known as Indo-Islamic architecture. Arches, domes, and minarets are the main features of this style. The Delhi Sultans built fort, mosque, palace, public buildings, madrasas, and dharmasthalas. Qutub Minar, Quwat-ul-Islam, Alay Darwaza, Juwaid Khana are the few examples of Indo-Islamic style.